Hello, my name's Jason Smith and I'm a tutor in materials science at Mansfield College. So I'm sorry we can't meet in person, but this video is to give you a bit of an introduction to the subject of materials science and hopefully to spark your interest. So many people ask, what is materials science? Well, materials are the stuff that we make things out of. It could be plastics for food packaging, or metals and alloys for the aerospace industry, or it could be semiconductors for making computer chips or lasers. They're all around us. And in fact, materials, if you think about it, have played a pivotal role in human history. We could name the Bronze Age, or the Iron Age, or the Silicon Age. So these are periods of time in which the harnessing the properties of individual materials has had a really profound and transformational impact on human development. Now, of course, not all materials have that much impact, but nevertheless, there are countless materials which play very important roles in all aspects of our daily lives. They underpin industry and manufacturing, and they determine the impact that we have on the environment in many different ways. So, understanding materials, developing materials, and, well, thinking about what we might be able to do with materials of the future, these are very much the pursuits of materials scientists. So, what are some of the big questions in modern day materials science? Well, there are many, but just a few might be things like, what materials will we use to build the next generation of computers, such as quantum computers, for example? In other words, can we engineer materials at the sort of atomic scale that will allow us to make use of quantum mechanical properties that will open up new possibilities in information technologies? Things like, can we make a superconducting material that will operate at ambient temperatures? This would be transformative in terms of our use of energy. Can we develop materials which would be able to confine plasmas in fusion reactors? This is a very hot topic of research at present. So there are many different questions in materials science which, if and when we answer them, could again have quite profound impacts on technology and on industry. So to answer these questions, clearly we're going to need to have lots of tools at our disposal. For example, we need to understand the basic physics which underpins materials. We need to understand the properties of atoms. We need to understand forces. We need to understand thermodynamics, and we need to understand phenomena like magnetism. We also need to know chemistry, because we need to know about the reactions that will allow us to synthesize and process materials, and perhaps reactions which will enable some functionality of materials, or reactions which will lead to the degradation of materials after they've used their useful life. So materials covers a wide range of different topics, a wide range of different disciplines. It also includes engineering, of course, because we need to know about the context in which materials are used. Some of the hardest questions in materials science are engineering questions, because, of course, for that we need to really sort of think about the whole use of the material, all of the different properties that the material needs to have, the circumstances in which it's going to be used, all of these different things. So it's really quite a multidisciplinary subject. The Oxford Materials course is designed to give you a thorough grounding in all these aspects of materials science. And of course, there's quite a lot of practical work as well. So you get to do some processing of materials and plenty of characterization of materials. And in the fourth year of the degree course, there is a part two project, which is a full year when you spend time within one of the research groups within the department on a project of your choosing, and really get stuck into some research and learn some skills in sort of project management, and get in depth into a topic. And that's an aspect of the course that students tend to really enjoy. So at the end of the four-year course, you're really sort of fully equipped for a career in industry, or to go into postgraduate research if that's your preference. There's also, of course, lots of fully sort of translatable skills that you get, as with any Oxford degree course in terms of sort of critical thinking, problem solving skills. These are all highly valued by employers, and our graduates go into a very wide range of subjects after they graduate. So that's the Oxford Materials course. Mansfield College takes on average 6 undergraduates in materials every year. So in total we have a community of about 30-odd materials scientists within Mansfield at any given time. And the college is just located about a 10-minute walk through the university parks from the materials department. So it's a great place to be. So I hope that this has been a useful video, bit of an introduction to materials at Oxford and at Mansfield. And I hope it's piqued your interest, and I hope to hear from you and perhaps see you at an interview at some stage. Bye-bye.